sure shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch Vanderlip is finally showing his true colors. Social climbing.
Old Senor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we go and get you down.
You son of a bitch.
We are ridiculous. Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I, if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There could be fine pickpockets.
Oh, no pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find some.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca, I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Tur, pesta-pesta mabuk ganteng kali ya. Lupa pakai pomade kita tuh.
Prima volta questo mese, senza dubbio.
Oh, this is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something. Although I'm not quite sure.
Mr. Hungry Cowboy.
Sandini High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Senor Bronte?
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me. Like that one. That wretch is the mayor. Henri Lemieux. He'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one too. That is Alberto Fusar. He owns a sugar plantation up on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. Oh, and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war, and a hero, they say, but this is his very young wife. I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things, yes, but a young wife, it's unseemly. Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, and a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that will save you. And that is Hector Fellows. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't have a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
None taken. All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very busy, and I won't waste any more of your time.
Yes. Go, enjoy yourselves, and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and scoop cows out from the open range.
Those sure were the days.
Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans?
Well, we've not made any. Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. Well, there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not myself in such matters. But you, as a guest, yes, as my guest, bah, do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Okay, ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me.
Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves. Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose, you go find us someplace to rob.
Deny idiocy, so, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. Yeah. What say you and me, cool off?
Get your hands off me.
Come on, sleep it off.
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. Rider?
Right. We seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
My lord, that's fantastic.
Monsieur Marquis,
Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
It's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come in and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Please say something about Cornwall. Yes, find out what.
Bonjour, monsieur.
What do you do there?
Find anything? I think so.
Nothing. This town is a waste of time.
Maybe not.
I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, man. I think I found out how we can grab some of the big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
The city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. We're gonna leave. That could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about. And I heard about a high
poker game. Come on. Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home!
I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk all so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it.
Mission complete.
Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are gonna run some distractions. See how the law reacts.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. Here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear. We are almost heading home.
Where is home?
I don't know. Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay.
Yes, and go. Abigail? Come on, play.
Sure is nice seeing the kid back around.
I don't know if I could have gone on longer.
On the past now.
Okay. Transfer me dulu.
Thank you for your help with Miss Jackson.
Don't mention it, Miss Grimshaw.
You're a fine man, Mr.
Walker. Thank you.
Some guts, kid. That's for sure.
Cangkul, cangkul. Kita mau jadi orang baru yang susah kan? Terakhir.
What are you reading?
mati langsung. Cuk. Dicengkar kita.
A damn good reason for being on my property, mister. Remember that loan you took, Mr. Davison? Well, time's long since up. I'm here to collect. I should have known. You goddamn bludgeon men are all the same. Sure, I got your money. Every stinking cent. It's in the house. Hell, I'll even offer you a drink. We can toast to never laying eyes on each other again. I got a powerful thirst on me right now. How about you? You gotta be stinking drunk already to do this kind of work.
I like doing it sober.
You take my money, surely you take a drink off me as well. That would be the mannerly thing to do.
Let's just handle the money first. Worry about manners later, okay? Catching flies, you weren't catching fish. Now come on, let's get us that death.
Someone's here, boy. Huh? Wait, what's going on?
Don't just stand there. Go fix us a drink.
Another one, Pop?
Don't give me no talk, boy. Just do it. I'll look down here for our savings.
Savings? Under the sink?
That's a place for. Now where's them drinks, boy?
Drinks ready. It's right there, miss.
It's our life savings. Come and take what you own.
Who's taking? It's right here. Thank you.
fine to me.
I ain't worth getting hanged for.
I'm fine with my decisions.
If you ain't a gentleman, well, I ain't a lady. Hands up now!
Hey, you bet. Damn well listen.
Wah, hilang lagi nih kita. Lari. Ya nampak makut kecil. Gimana boy yang gak kelihatan? lumpur aligatornya.
You know, I'll just come back later.
No, you ain't. I don't
Mr. Morgan,
you.
Bring me some materials, and I'll be glad.
Now I think you're a fine, upstanding gentleman who got stuck in the wrong place. Something like that.
Okay.